Hello and welcome to another episode of Community Connections. This is Region 1 News. My name is Sam Otero, coming to you from the Gum Springs Community Center Studios. And today we're going to learn about another resource and a little bit about the technology and the programming that they offer at the Sherwood Regional Library, just up the road from the Gum Springs Community Center. Joining us today on Community Connections, Joy Jackson, who is the Information Services Librarian, kind of a high-tech librarian. Is that what we got going on, Joy?
I am. I'm a librarian, but I'm also the tech lab manager here at Sherwood. And if you're not familiar with the tech lab at Sherwood, it's a brand new space. We opened in January of 2020. And it's Fairfax County Public Library's first makerspace. So we've got all kinds of goodies. We've got iPads, Apple Pencils, we've got robots, we've got green screens, we've got 3D printers. Just about anything you can do to make something, we have it at the Tech Lab.
Welcome to the Tech Lab. Come on in, take a look. So this is the Tech Lab. We've got all kinds of stuff here for you to use. We've got the green screen over to your right. We've got a paper cutter machine, their Cri-Cut Silhouette. We've got sewing machines. We've got soldering kits. We have microscopes. We've got spheros. We've got Legos. We've got our 3D printers. We have our Memory Depot. Just about anything you could think of to make and create, we have here in the Tech Lab. And pre-pandemic, you could come in and visit us almost every day and try out some of our cool products that we have. And we're hoping post-pandemic to offer those services again. So be on the lookout for when we reopen and come in and say hi and play with some of our toys.
Well, tell us a little bit about the makerspace. Define that for us. I mean, this is a learning opportunity for young people. Of course, they're having fun and engaging with technology, but tell us a little bit about the educational component and some of what you were doing there in person. And then it's my understanding that you guys are now offering, like we are, some online educational opportunities as well, right? So tell us a little bit about that makerspace.
Absolutely. So a makerspace is basically a space where you come to learn and create. And makerspaces often offer the equipment, the tools, and the education to help you do that. So, as I mentioned, we offer different equipment. Spheros are little robots, but you can use those robots to learn how to code. And so we offer a class on how to code using our little robots. We also offered how to create your own PC classes. So you came in and you were given the pieces and we walked you through how to create your own PC. So it's about helping you learn how to create, and not just in technology, but also with art. So coming up, we're going to be offering virtual classes like a Hacker High School for teens. We're going to also offer something called Makerspace Mondays, which is twice a month. You can join us virtually and we'll create something. And it'll usually be something STEAM related. So science, technology, engineering, art, or math. So those are the types of things that we do in the Tech Lab. Right now, it's not as hands-on as we'd like, but going forward, when we reopen normally, we'll have more hands-on activities, more that you can do in the branch.
Sounds very similar to what we're doing at the Clubhouse Technology centers here in Fairfax County.
Right.
STEAM-based education, project-based learning. That's awesome. I'm looking forward to collaborating with you. I'm glad I met you. This is really very cool.
Absolutely.
And you're
right
down the road from us as well. I have never myself seen a library that has a tech center built into it. So explain to us how this works. This is a county library, publicly funded, traditional library model. Where does the tech center figure into that?
So we are located at the Sherwood Regional Library on the second floor.
Okay.
We are first of its kind for Fairfax County Public Libraries,
And it's
and
funded
it
by
was
the
created.
county, the same library funding source?
No, so actually it was by the Friends of Sherwood Library.
Oh,
So
interesting. Okay. That's what I was
they
getting at. I
provided.
was wondering how did this come about? Because that's a pretty innovative model. I've never seen this in a community that I've lived in before.
Right, yes. So they were very generous and very kind to provide us with the funds to make this happen. And because they were, we were able to start something that we didn't have before in the county. So we're super excited to have this space, and we're looking forward to what we can do and what our community members can help us do with it.
Absolutely. Well, Joy, tell us a little bit about you. Tell us about Joy Jackson and your experience with STEAM education. How'd you get into this?
So I have a minor in information technology. I've taught technology classes in the past, and I've really, really enjoyed it. So when I applied for this position, it was right up my alley. I was like, I can help people with technology, I can be creative, and I can work with people, which is what I really enjoy. So I come from an academic library background where you have to do a lot of teaching. And then I get to do programming here as a public librarian, which I really enjoy. So it's just the perfect position for everything that I love to do as a librarian.
Well, good for you, and I appreciate what you're doing in the community. Looking forward to working with you, doing some co-teaching, collaborating, and it'll be great for you to come into the Gathering STEAM after-school program that we have here and do some activities with the kids. That'd be great. Great way to introduce them to you and your program over there.
Oh, absolutely. I can't wait. So just tell me when and where, and I'll show up.
That's really awesome. I really appreciate this. Contact information, how do they get hold of you guys, should they choose to do so?
Best way to get in contact with us, anyone at the library, is to go to the library's website. That's fairfaxcounty.gov/library. That way you can find the branch closest to you and find the contact information to get in touch with us.
Outstanding. Joy Jackson, thank you so much. And I've got to take a trip down there someday and visit you guys and check out your tech center. I'm looking forward to working with you.
Oh, absolutely. Thank you so much for having me on.
Absolutely. Thanks for coming on Community Connections. Talk to you soon.